So today we're going to be reading a book called Who is Afraid of the Dark? Can anybody tell me what's on the cover of the book? Yeah, a fox, an owl, a few houses.
Who's here is afraid of the dark?
Maybe him.
It's okay if you are. A lot of people are. It's a common fear. So, our main character is the fox, who is also afraid of the dark,
but we'll see what happens throughout the book.
Who's afraid of the dark?
If you go into the dark and tiptoe about at night, nothing will look the same as it does when it's light. The sun will sink from the sky, and the moon will shine big and round. Shapes will creep from the moon and stretch along the ground.
But there's no need to worry,
or for you to be afraid. The shapes are only shadows that the branches of trees have made.
It's true, the dark is full of things that creep and crack and moan,
things that jump, things that bump, and things that crumble and groan.
But you'll find it's just a badger
munching on a midnight snack, shuffling over twigs and sticks along the forest track.
Perhaps he'll stop for a chat
or play a game or two. Then he'll be on his way and wave goodbye and say thank you.
If you do go into the dark,
always remember to look behind. Because lurking in the shadows, who knows what you might find. Bats could fly out of the trees and get tangled in your hair. Or suddenly you'll hear a snap and ask, is anybody there? Has anybody ever seen a bat before? I have, but usually when I go camping. What would you do if you saw a bat?
It'll only be the night owl
swooping through the sky. Hoo, hoo, he'll say to you as he goes flying by.
The fluffy
owlet in the nest might sing a song for you. They'll flap their little wings and go twit, twit, twoo.
But are these really monsters hiding in places you can't see? And do you think to yourself, are they following me?
Don't worry, it's only a hedgehog shuffling by the wall, making their way back to their houses. They're not monsters at all. Has anyone ever seen a hedgehog? Where have you seen them? Right, they're usually at pet stores because hedgehogs don't live in the United States in the wild. They're originally from New Zealand and Australia. So usually we just have them as pets. If you go into the dark and miss the daytime sun, remember that playing in the moonlight can really be lots of fun. You can splash in glittering pools and watch the little fish. If a shooting star zooms by, then you can make a magic wish. When you hear a screech and a scratch, or maybe a distant howl, it will only be a guard dog, or maybe a cat on the prowl.
Does any of you have dogs or dogs in their neighborhood?
So most of us are used to hearing dogs bark, right? So at night, it shouldn't be scary because we know what it is.
You'll hear noises at night
and wonder, what could they be? It doesn't mean they're scary just because you can't see.
So if you're afraid of the dark and think you should beware,
remember that you're not alone and someone will always be there.
You'll get a hug and a kiss,
and maybe a story too. Then you'll yawn and know that it really is bedtime for you.
You'll just curl up safe and warm in the glow of the light and think of all the things that you saw in the night. You might hear a snap, a hoot, a crack, or a bark, but you'll know just what it is, and you won't be afraid of the dark. Did we see in the book? Right, there was owls, foxes like our main characters, a hedgehog. At the beginning of the book, the fox was scared of the dark, right? Just like a lot of us. But at the end, was he? No, because he knew what all the noises were in the dark, so he wasn't scared of them anymore. Why was the fox out at night? Usually, foxes go out at night because they're nocturnal. Animals that are nocturnal go out at night. We're not nocturnal because we usually go out during the day. Thanks for reading with me, guys.